do not like making decisions. Wait, wait. They want a man to make the decisions.
Jesse, when do you go?
Yeah, obviously, he's disgusting. He's terrible. He's a sexist, misogynist. Hence, the leading candidate to take Tucker Carlson's job.
Cenk was right. Jesse Waters will be taking over Tucker Carlson's time slot on Fox News. In fact, Fox News just announced its primetime lineup, and Jesse Waters will be taking over that time slot, and other people will be moved around. Just to give you some more information on that. No, in fact, before I get to those details, Cenk, how does it feel to be right about your prediction?
Look, I'm not saying that hashtag Cenk was right should be trending on Twitter. I'm not saying that.
No one trends on Twitter for good reasons.
Well, that's true, and I often trend on Twitter. Anyways, all right, look, this story. I predicted that Jesse Waters thing a couple of times, and I also said Greg Gutfeld would get one of the shows, and you're gonna see that also happen. And the reason for that is you have to stop thinking like you. You have to think like the other side. And that's a huge problem for most people. It's hard to see outside your own perspective. So as we look at Jesse Waters and Greg Gutfeld, and they always make the sexist jokes, sometimes race jokes, etc. You think, oh, that's terrible. I mean, they're probably not gonna go with them. No, that means they're almost certainly gonna go with them. They're trying to replace a guy who built his career and their great ratings based on all the worst parts of the right wing, right? There's some good parts of the right wing. Am I not merciful, right? But like the bigotry, the racism, the corruption, the conspiracy theories, etc. So they wanted to find someone as close to as obnoxious as Tucker Carlson as they could, and that is gonna be Jesse Dirty Waters.
My take is a little different. I mean, remember, Tucker got fired. I don't think they want to replace someone they fired with someone as similar to Tucker as possible.
So I do.
You do? Okay.
Yeah, but with a giant caveat, which I think is what you're kind of getting at here, which is you do everything that Tucker did, except when we tell you to heal, you heal. Mm. Okay, so we're in charge. We own this place. You don't. So be a good boy and do as you're told. Attack the other side. And when we tell you to stop or when we tell you to go forward, you listen to the Murdochs. You get it, boy? And that's the speech I guarantee you they had with Jesse Waters. And Jesse Waters' reaction was this. Yeah, I totally get it. I told you, give me the money, give me the money, give me the money. I'll do whatever you say.
I just don't know if Jesse Waters is gonna succeed. Like, you get what I'm saying?
Yeah, I don't know.
So I guess we'll see.
But he might. I mean, he's a prick, and that's what the viewers on Fox, let's be honest, that's what they like. And they already like Greg Gutfeld, and he's another prick.
They're definitely pricks, like I'll agree with that. So let's get to the rest of the lineup. So according to a press release that was put out by Fox News, the Ingraham angle will be kicking off primetime at 7 p.m. Eastern, followed by Jesse Waters primetime, which is moving to 8 p.m. Eastern. Then you have Hannity remaining at 9 p.m. and then Gutfeld with an exclamation mark shifts to 10 p.m. Eastern time. So
that's a slight problem for Laura Ingraham. It's not a big deal from move to 10 to 7. She was at 10. But it is a little bit of a demotion. 8 is the best. 8 and 9 are arguably the best. Mm-hmm. Okay. Sometimes people think it's 8, sometimes they think it's 9. But then 10 and then 7.
Okay? All of this stuff feels. Look, I get that their audience is older, so it is not antiquated when you think about it in that context, yeah, and their viewership. But when you think about it in the context of pretty much everyone else and how they consume media, it's just hilarious. I was like, oh, the prime time, 10 o'clock, better than 7 o'clock, because you know, you gotta rush home and make sure you're there in front of a TV as soon as this show goes live. By the way, shout out to our live viewers, I love you guys. But it is an antiquated concept.
So you got that, plus with Fox News it's a little bit different because their audience is literally average age of 70 years old. Half the audience is above 70 years old. That's why the 5 does so well, because it's the early bird special.
Hell yeah.
So normally 5 o'clock is way too early to do that well in television, in old media. But except at Fox, they're like, oh, 5 o'clock, right before we go, before we pass out for the night, let's watch this. So, but now they're taking Jesse Waters off the 5 to give him his own. But 8 o'clock is as sweet as it gets, so Waters has gotta be pumped. Thanks for watching the Young Turks, really appreciate it. Another way to show support is through YouTube memberships. You'll get to interact with us more. There's live chat, emojis, badges. You've got emojis of me, Anna, John, JR. So those are super fun. But you also get playback of our exclusive member only shows and specials right after they air. So all of that, all you gotta do is click that join button right underneath the video. Thank you.